Welcome to MISUMI's new 19-minute webinar series. For those of you here that are new to MISUMI, MISUMI is a global supplier of configurable components. You may ask, why configurable? What is it? Configurable components solve the designer's dilemma. A designer has two choices for components, standard or custom. Standard components have limited selection and often force designers to compromise their designs. These many pluses, such as CAD, static part numbers, fast delivery, often seem inexpensive and convenient. The other choice is custom. Custom components have many drawbacks. Designers have to make the solid models themselves in all the manufacturing drawings. Purchasers, too, can attest to the long wait for quotes, the expensive setup charges for short runs, and the long lead times. We are forced to use custom components, though, because of the flexibility. MISUMI offers configurable, which is the best of both, easy and flexible. Configurable components are easy to design with and purchase. Online, select the product geometry desired, the material and surface finish. Input the size for each configurable dimension within the range and increment shown. You'll get a smart part number, instant price and days to ship, and the CAD model. All of this configurability is available with our over 1 million components, available at MISUMIUSA.com. Now, I'll turn it over to our MISUMI engineer.
Hi, my name is Yau-Han from the engineering department at MISUMI USA. In this session, I will be focusing on MISUMI's linear shafts. One of MISUMI's key product offerings are shaft and rods that differ in price point and tolerances for their different applications. MISUMI linear shafts are typically used in conjunction with our linear bushings that ride along the length of the shaft. The dimension accuracy of the linear shaft is very important because it ensures that the linear bushing is accurately sliding along. The first measurement of accuracy is the D-section circularity as seen in the diagram. For hardened shafts, the circularity tolerance is as low as 4 microns. For non-hardened shafts, the tolerance is as low as 11 microns. This is critical as the tolerance needs to fit with the linear bushing that will be paired with the shaft. MISUMI uses GIS standards to control the dimensional tolerance of our linear shafts. The tolerance classes offered are G6, H5, and F8, as seen on the table. This is a snapshot of the GIS shaft fit tolerance table that can be found in the technical data section of our catalog. Please note that MISUMI shafts with an F8 tolerance are only offered in non-hardened materials. Non-hardened shafts are not recommended for the use with linear ball bushings. The next tolerance specification is the length tolerance that is not as critical, as the shaft ends are normally mounted. As you can see, the length tolerance can range from 0.1 to 1.2 millimeters, depending on the length of the shaft ordered. The most critical tolerance on a linear shaft is the straightness, as the linear bushing requires a straight shaft in order to travel smoothly during operation. As you can see, the straightness tolerance for hardened shafts are as low as 0.01 millimeters per 100 millimeters or less. Non-hardened shafts are 0.025 millimeters per 100 millimeters or less. Also measured are the concentricity and perpendicularity of each shaft. The perpendicularity tolerance measures 0.03 millimeters for precision type shafts and 0.2 millimeters for standard. The concentricity tolerance of MISUMI linear shafts measures 0.2 millimeters for precision type and 0.1 millimeters for standard types. Linear shafts are all made of steel, but standard carbon steel is respectively soft and wears quite easily. Because linear bushings travel directly on the linear shafts, it is important to note a key feature. All MISUMI linear shafts are induction hardened, also known as case hardened, or surface treated to withstand the wear of the bushing riding directly on the shaft. The common practice in bearing steel technology is to induction harden the steel to increase the hardness of the surface, thereby withstanding the wear of the contacting surfaces. Induction hardening is achieved by heat treating the metal using a special treatment to pull the carbon atoms towards the surface of the metal. This will create a hardened case with a soft core, resulting in a more wear-resistant material. The induction-hardened linear shafts offered by MISUMI are 52-100 bearing steel with a hardness of at least 58 HRC, and 440C stainless steel with a hardness of at least 56 HRC. MISUMI offers a hard chrome plating for our line of linear shafts. Hard chrome plating offers additional wear resistance to the material along with increased abrasion resistance. This plating can be applied to induction-hardened or non-hardened metals. MISUMI also offers a low-temperature black chrome plating for our linear shafts for the 52-100 bearing steel material option. Low-temperature black chrome plating offers our highest corrosion resistance while maintaining a very high precision tolerance. This coating has a thickness of about 1 to 2 microns. So why are there so many material and coating options? MISUMI understands that every application is different, and depending on the environment, high corrosive protection may be required. Here is a sample of a 168-hour salt water test on the different finishes offered by MISUMI. As you can see, our most cost-effective 52-100 bearing steel option is not recommended for highly corrosive environments. Depending on the severity of the environment, MISUMI offers different levels of protection, with low-temperature black chrome plating as the highest level of corrosion resistance. Linear shafts can be specified with the following materials: 52-100 bearing steel, 440C stainless steel, 1045 carbon steel, and 304 stainless steel. MISUMI also allows for the option of hard chrome plating and low temperature black chrome plating for certain material options. Now that we have a good understanding of linear shafts, let's take a look at MISUMI's offerings. Our two main categories for linear shafts are solid shafts and hollow shafts. These can then be broken down into selectable end shapes that can then be further specified into a configurable shaft. MISUMI offers over 60 configurable shafts. In addition to the 60 plus configurable shapes, MISUMI offers alterations that can be applied to your shaft design. These alterations include changing the shaft length tolerance to a higher precision level. This alteration also allows you to specify the shaft length in 0.1mm increments instead of the standard 1mm increment. Adding one or two sets of wrench flats. You can specify the location of the wrench flats on the shaft. These flats allow you to easily grip a shaft with a wrench when additional tightening is required. Adding set screw flats to a shaft. You can specify the location and size of the flat. MISUMI also offers an alteration that allows you to add two set screw flats at the same location, 90 degrees from each other. The flat is used to prevent the round surface of the shaft from being damaged when clamping the shaft in place with a set screw. Adding one or two V-grooves to a shaft. You can specify the location of the V-grooves. V-grooves can be used for D-collars or collars with holes for proper orientation. Adding one or two keyways to a shaft. You can specify the size and location of the keyways. Keyways can be used for oscillating motion applications to help maintain proper orientation. Changing the thread pitch for both external and internal threads. The standard thread pitch is always coarse for MISUMI shafts. This alteration allows you to select a finer thread pitch when necessary. MISUMI also offers an additional alteration that adds an undercut to the threaded portion of a shaft. Alteration availability is dependent upon the shaft type and size. Let's visit MISUMI's website and show an example of a configured shaft. This is MISUMI's globally recognized homepage. MISUMI is divided into three divisions: automation components, press die components, and plastic mold components. We will be focusing on the automation components for this webinar, so I will select the automation components icon. The Automation Components homepage showcases our major product categories on the left-hand side and the subcategories in the pictorial index on the right. For this session, we are focusing on the linear shafts. From here, you can narrow down your search by either filtering down on the left-hand side or scrolling through the descriptions for your exact match. You can also click on the photo button to see larger pictures of each product or details for a side-by-side technical comparison. For this example, I will select one end tapped and stepped on the filter column. Now you can see that I only have three options to select. By selecting the first option, the site will take me to the part detail page where I can make my final specifications for my shaft. On the part detail page, also known as the configurator, you will see that the default drawing view with the blue configurable dimensions. These blue dimensions can be specified in increments as low as 0.1 millimeters for some shaft types. For this example, I will start by going down the left-hand selection column and begin selecting my desired configuration. For material, I will select 52-100 bearing steel. For surface treatment, I will select not provided, as I do not want any surface treatment. And the diameter of my shaft will be 12 millimeters. For hardness, the only option I can select is induction hardened. The diameter tolerance for my shaft will be G6. Next, I can manually enter a shaft length in 1mm increments. In this case, I will select 153mm. For the precision grade, I will select standard type. For the F dimension, I can reference the drawing to see that it represents the length of the left stepped end. I will enter 20mm for this length. Now I will select my thread size from the selection menu. I will choose 6mm thread. Since I have identified enough of my shaft specifications, the part type will appear and indicate in red highlights the remaining dimensions required to complete the part number. I will continue to reference this drawing for the final dimension P in order to complete my part number. P will equal 9. As mentioned in the previous slide, we can also add alterations to the shaft. By clicking on the More Options icon, the Specifications tab, we can see all the available alterations for the shaft type. You can then input the alteration value in the left-hand specification column to add it to your part. For this example, we will leave this blank. After completing all the selections, you will get a part number that is recognized globally. We can now click on the Price Check icon to find the price and delivery information for this part. Our standard one-piece price for the shaft configuration is $28.02 with no minimum orders. As for the delivery, the shaft will ship from our warehouse in 3 business days or less. To find out more about the delivery options, we can click on the Days to Ship tab. In this case, the shaft has an Express A option for $8 a piece. To find out what this express option means, you can click here to see the details. Looking at this chart, we see that the items with a standard delivery of 3 days, with an express A option selected, expedites your shaft order to 1 day. That means you can have a completely configured shaft, machined to your specification, ordered with a part number, no minimum order quantity, shipped to you in 1 day for an additional $8. Think of the added cost from your local machine shop to expedite one piece of the same shaft. Now that we have completed our part, we can download the 3D CAD model by selecting the CAD download preview icon and then selecting the 3D download Go Configure selection. Before actually downloading, we can select the preview tab to make sure that the shaft looks correct to our specifications. Once verified, click on the CAD Data Download tab to download your MISUMI shaft available in many formats, including SOLIDWORKS and Inventor, or non-native formats such as STEP. Now that you understand MISUMI's configurable business model, you can see how standardizing simple machine products can save you time and money. No detailed drawings are required. No CAD drawing administration, especially replacement parts and revision levels. MISUMI is making configurable the new standard. Here are some examples of different shaft ends. Retaining ring grooves for bearing housings, hex holes for hex keys, one end threaded or tap for mounting, straight for standard shaft supports, two tap holes for anti-rotation, one end tapered for locating purposes, one end step to reduced housing sizes. Next, we will review some customer-submitted industry examples using MISUMI linear shafts. The first design is for material testing. A combination of linear shafts, linear bushings, and other components are used to create a fatigue tester. The upper portion of the workpiece holder is connected to two linear bushings which travel along the shaft, allowing for accurate and easy movement of the mechanism. This design uses hardened linear shafts to prevent deformation from occurring between the shaft and bushing while maintaining the precision necessary to properly perform the fatigue test. The next example uses linear shafts to create a fixture assembly commonly used in the automotive industry. The slide unit is driven by a manually operated lead screw assembly that is guided by a set of linear shafts and bushings. The linear shafts are held in place by split shaft supports, which clamp onto the ends of the shaft. This removes the need for machining at the shaft ends while still providing precise linear motion. In addition, the linear shafts also provide support for the loads applied to the assembly. This example shows a simple way of providing linear motion in a vertical application using linear shafts. In this application, there is no effective way to utilize linear guides since they require continuous support along the entire rail. Utilizing linear shafts allows for more design freedom when specialized components can be incorporated. In this particular case, the linear shafts are press fit into a metal bracket that serves several functions, including a shaft support. This helps reduce the total number of parts required to achieve the necessary linear motion and reduce the overall size of the mechanism. This model is for a vertical product placement machine used in the electronics industry. The vertical motion of the inspection platform is achieved with a ball screw assembly. The ball screw assembly is driven by a servo motor and guided by linear shafts. Since the inspection platform is lightweight, the moment load is minimal and inexpensive linear shafts can be used instead of linear guides. The final application example is an assembly station for smaller electronic components. Air cylinders are used with the linear shafts and linear guides to achieve simultaneous horizontal and vertical motion. These linear shafts help displace the applied loads and improve the overall accuracy of the assembly. This is an excellent example of the versatility of linear shafts in applications where it is not possible to use linear guides. Our last example shows a simple linear actuator assembly that is completely made up of MISUMI components. We showcased our linear shafts in this presentation, but MISUMI offers a wide range of supporting product, such as bushings, shaft supports, collars, and many other components to complete your automation assembly needs.
Thank you, and we hope you enjoyed today's webinar. All of MISUMI's configurable components and 1 million products are available at www.misumiusa.com. If you are new to MISUMI, register for access to CAD downloads, online formal quotes and orders, and manage all of your account histories. For first-time companies purchasing, you can receive 30% off. Full support is also available. Technical help at engineering@misumiusa.com, customer service at inquire, and your local account manager at sales. Facebook now has our 19-minute video series available to view at your leisure. Connect with us to join the conversation and see exclusive content. Thank you again.